everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video we are going to talking about the external ocular examination. So before starting, if you have not already watched the previous videos of the ophthalmology on my YouTube channel playlist, then please go and watch them for better understanding, because in this video I am not going in detail of every terminology. So let's start with the external ocular examination. First is the examination of the head posture, which is abnormal in the paralytic squint to avoid the diplopia and incomplete ptosis. Now the examination of the forehead and the facial symmetry, which is increase in wrinkle in the ptosis and decrease in the lower motor neuron palsy, and the facial symmetry is abnormal in the Bell's palsy. The eyebrows level is the change in the ptosis. Examination of the eye and the position, normal lower lid just touch the limbus and outer lid cover 1/6 of the cornea, that is 2 mm. It is more than 1/6. The movement of the lid blinking is 12 to 16 blinks per minute normal. Increase in the irritation, decrease in the seventh nerve palsy. The leg of thalamus, which is unable to close eye. Lid margins may be entropion, ectropion, trichiasis, scales at the margin, which is in blepharitis and swelling in the sty and papilloma. The palpebral aperture, which is decreased vertical aperture in the ptosis, enophthalmos and anophthalmos. The wide vertically with thalamus, retraction of upper lid and facial nerve palsy. The examination of the lacrimal apparatus by the lacrimal sac, the swelling and redness seen, polylacrimal puncture, eversion, stenosis and discharge. Regurgitation test is a pressing lacrimal sac area just medial to the medial canthus and see any regurgitation discharge. It is positive in the dacryocystitis and negative in the internal fistula. The examination of the eyeball, the position line joining the central point of the superior and inferior orbital margin just touch the cornea, abnormal in the exophthalmos and anophthalmos. Prolepsis is abnormal in the squint. The size is increased in the brophthalmos and decrease in the congenital microphthalmos. The movement is unilocular as well as bilocular in the all six cardinal direction of the eye. The examination of the conjunctiva, both bulbar and palpebral conjunctiva. The discoloration in the anemia, cyanosis, subconjunctival hemorrhage. The congestion of vessels in the keratitis, acute congestive glaucoma, the edema, follicles and foreign bodies, scar, pterygium, cyst, tumor. Sclera may be discoloration, inflammation, staphyloma, perforation. Yeah. The corneal examination. The cornea is the like pouch glass with a uniform posterior surface in it, the central area. The shape abnormal in the keratoconus, surface is smoothness, decrease in the abrasion, ulcer, scar, transparency lost in the corneal edema, opacity, ulceration, degeneration. Corneal vasculation, sensations, reflexes. The corneal epithelium, by microscopy examination after staining of the cornea with the vital stain, the fluorescence staining, one drop, 2% fresh aqueous solution of the dye or the disposal autoclave filter paper strip impregnated in the dye. The aid unit of epithelium due to abrasion and corneal scar become brilliant green. The other dye used, Benger's rose, 1% alicin blue. The examination of the anterior chamber. The depth of the AC is normal, 2.5 mm in the center. The shallow in the hypermetropia, malignant glaucoma, anterior perforation, anterior subluxation of length. The deep in the aphakia, myopia, posterior synecdoche, brophthalmos, keratoconus, posterior perforation. The abnormal content may be aqueous flare, hypopyon, foreign body, crystalline lens, bloods, and cysts. The examination of the iris. Normal color is the dark brown. And change in the color in the heterochromia iridium, the different color of the two iris. Heterochromia iridium is different color of the sectors of the same iris. It is lighter in the heterochromia Horner syndrome chronic uveitis, darker in the hemosiderosis retained foreign body, malignant melanoma and lymphomas. The pattern may be muddy iris in the acute erythrocytitis, persistent pupillary membrane, the synecdoche, adhesions of the iris to the other intraocular structures, nodules, gap of the whole cyst. Examination of the pupil. The number is more than one pupil in the congenita. Size may be small in the meiosis, erythrocytitis, Horner syndrome, heart injury, strong light during sleep, pupil is pinpoint. The larger in the midriasis, acute congestive glaucoma, midriatics, optic atrophy, retinal detachment, belladonna poisoning. The shape is irregular, narrow. In the erythrocytitis, festone pupil, irregular pupil obtained after the patchy dilatation. The normal color is the grayish black, the jet black in the aphakia, grayish white in mature senile cortical cataract, pearly white in mature cortical cataract, milky white in hypermature cataract, brownish black in the cataract nigra, leukocoria white reflexing pupil, which in the retinoblastoma, yellow white semi dilated non reactive pupil, amaurotic cat's eye reflex, the greenish blue in the glaucoma, maybe. The pupillary reflexive we can check. The examination of the lens, the position, dislocation, subluxation, aphakia, pseudoaphakia. The shape is the lenticonus, posterior and the anterior. The color in the old age, the grayish white in the cortical cataract, the grayish white in immature, the pearly white in the mature, the milky white in the hypermature. The brown or black nuclear cataract, the rusty orange cataract, such lens with the siderosis in UV, the transparency in the any opacity in the cataract, UV deposit and the Purkinje images. The examination of the intraocular pressure, the digital tonometry, the 10 to 21 mmHg is the normal pressure, decrease in the retinal detachment, erythrocytitis and increase in the glaucoma. Thank you.